Hello everyone, I'm Katie.
Chad.
Montrez, and welcome to
Let's Get Social,
a series that teaches you all the basics of social media
marketing.
And welcome to the first episode of Let's Get Social. I'm Montrez, and today I'll be interviewing our KUSBDC social media and marketing expert, Katie, on all the basics of utilizing social media within a small business.
Thank you for having me.
No problem, Katie. So, today social media seems to be catching on very quickly for small businesses. Why do you think that is?
Absolutely. Everyone recently has been talking about social media for a good reason. It's a great launchpad to put your business in the minds of people that are going to be using your products, that are looking to you for more information, and to put your business in the minds of people that are going to be using your products. So while social media shouldn't be in place of other forms of marketing, it's a great tool for customer engagement, PR, exposure, and networking. These are all things that can enhance the images and the brands of your small business.
Okay. So since you're interacting with so many different people at once, it seems like it would be a good idea to sort of stay up to date while you're online. So making sure you're posting often.
Absolutely. Yep. So staying current and being lively on social media is crucial for small businesses and large ones too, to communicate with their customers. Some ways would be to be posting your promotions or advertisements for that week, engaging with your customers on your posts, and talk about events that might be going on. You know, just kind of staying with them and keeping them up to date on everything that's going on.
So around about how many people do you think are using social media to access information? And are small businesses able to reach a lot of people using social media?
They are, absolutely. There are over 1 billion active Facebook users. And they share about 2.5 billion pieces of information every day. Nearly 28% of all online time is spent on social media platforms. So just there, you're reaching a lot of people at once. And people are using about 3 hours of their day on all social media platforms. Additionally, 79% of Twitter users are more likely to buy from brands that they follow. So even just having followers is going to be, you know, already putting you in the minds of so many customers. 80% of all Americans use a social media network, and those numbers are steadily rising.
It's break time!
Oh, well, hello there. Welcome to break time. Hey, I have a joke for you. I found this pretty funny. So a journalist walks in and says to a very successful businessman, "I just have a few questions to ask you," and the businessman says, "Okay, sure, go ahead." And the journalist says, "Just out of curiosity, how many employees do you have working for you?" And the successful businessman says, "Good question. I'd say only about half." Thank you, I'll be here all week. Not really. See you next week.
Well, those seem like very promising numbers to small businesses. And it seems like using the social media can have a positive impact on their business.
Mm-hmm.
So do you have any tips and tricks for entrepreneurs who are looking to grow their social media presence? And also, how do you think people should go about using social media more effectively in small businesses?
There are so many tips and tricks out there for using social media to help drive your return on investment. Also by using key performance indicators or KPIs to measure the effectiveness of the campaigns that you're developing. And you can get a clearer look at how social media can help your business. Some of the major do's that I would recommend paying attention to are knowing your audience. What do they like to do? Where are they? What sites are they on? Always spell check and use proper grammar. This helps you look more credible and knowledgeable. Be active. Staying current is so important. Because if you're posting just, you know, once a month, people don't know what's going on. You're not up to date on your social media. Developing your voice. This is really imperative to branding your business, so your voice should carry across all of your social media platforms. Be timely, especially if there's any complaints or problems on your social media that people are posting. By being timely and responding to those customers, it makes for really good interaction. That also follows along with having great customer service, both online and in your stores. Also, imposing a social media policy for all employees is important. So you should only really have one person posting so that you keep that branded voice and make sure that if people are tagging your company that work for you, they are ambassadors of your company. So they should be behaving accordingly. And knowing which platforms your audience is using, this helps to get out your info efficiently and effectively. That way you're not posting on places that they're not even going to see it.
I think those are great suggestions for small business owners to start getting started with their online presence. Are there any other things that should be avoided?
Always. There's always a way to conduct social media well and then not so well. So some of the things that I would avoid are, don't neglect any social media outlet that you create. If you only have time to really update one, only stick with that one until you have time to do another. And also don't have multiple people posting like we talked about previously. That way you would lose your voice that you've developed for your company. Sometimes you see companies bashing other companies on social media, and that doesn't look so great. So important, don't make spelling or grammar mistakes. Don't ignore the problems or issues that your customers are posting about. Don't post the same info dozens of times. This kind of spams your followers. Every time that you follow a company and they post the same thing three times a day, it's like you get it. And don't be boring. Be creative with it. Social media is a chance to kind of have fun and to branch out.
That's all we have time for today. In episode 2, we will talk about when's the best time to share, how active you should be on each platform, how to engage your followers, and finding your brand's voice. Also, please visit www.kutztownsbdc.org to learn more about our upcoming events and workshops available to you. Thanks for watching, and as always, stay social, America. Bye!
Hello. Could you follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and connect with us on LinkedIn? Much appreciated. Bye.